Me again. I thought I'd do I'd set the video camera up on the knees of the slat so I can have my hands free. I've been using, one of the great things about making your own materials is that you're not frightened of playing around with it. So I've been trying all different sorts of things, and one of the aspects I like about this pastel is that it is has that it's not very permanent, and when I was young starting out painting, I was obsessed with studying techniques and using materials, and I read all the books and about how to use material. I never went to art school, but I taught myself through books. And I think I know more than most people who've gone to art school about materials. And I make things. But I was obsessed with permanence. I was wanting to do paintings that were going to last forever because I was going to be a great artist. Now, I realise I'm not. And you get more realistic. And you also, as you get older, I'm in the last couple of decades of my life, you realise that it's all pointless striving for something that's permanent, and most of the art done, modern art, is all falling off the walls, and if they decide it's worthy of being precious and in a gallery, they'll spend heaps of money on gluing all the little flakes of paint back on the canvas. So, and people like me that have done paintings that last really well, that stuff ends up in a bloody garage sale, so who the fuck cares? Sorry. Anyway, so I kind of like the idea of doing something that's not permanent now. Anyway, I'm rabbiting. So what I was going to do was just, I've been using a dilute solution of like water and the gum tragonoth, which is the binder essentially, and you can use that and it will turn it into basically paint, poster paint or something, and then work over the top of it again with a dry pastel, and that kind of fixes it in a way. Degas used pastel. He used it over the top of monoprints, and I'm not sure whether he did it while the ink was wet. I've always loved his pastels. It's a medium I've always loved. I did a series of, when I was doing hands, I did a series of hands in pastel that I've got somewhere. And again, I noticed the first ones I did faded really badly, so because of the cheap pigments that were in the pastels I was using. It was one of the reasons I wanted to go to making my own, because I can use permanent pigments, so I'm contradicting myself already. Is this the way? But yeah, I mean, I don't deliberately want to make things that are going to be not permanent. I don't really know. Who knows? But anyway, it doesn't matter. There it is. So,